Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video of StudyIQ, I will bring to you the current affairs of 4th of December. So let's start the video. Before I start, I would like to discuss the questions which were asked in one of the exams sent to me by one of the students. Prime Minister of which country, Abe Ahmed Ali, he won the 2019 Nobel Prize for resolving the border conflict with Eritrea. So Abe Ahmed Ali is the Prime Minister of Ethiopia. And he resolved the border conflict with Eritrea. The president of Ethiopia is Sahle Work Zewde. Where was the 17th edition of the IAAF World Athletics Championship conducted? The country that topped the medal tally in this was America and Doha. It was organized in Qatar, Doha. Qatar will also host the 2020 Club World Cup and 2022 FIFA Men's Football World Cup. In October 2019, the World Habitat Day was observed on which date? World Habitat Day is the first Monday of October, and this time the first Monday of October was on 7th of October. So the answer is 7th of October. Which typhoon triggered floods and landslides in Japan? The typhoon is Hagibis typhoon. In which city of Tamil Nadu Prime Minister Modi met Chinese President Xi Jinping in October 2019? It was the second informal summit in Mamallapuram. It took place in Mamallapuram in India in Tamil Nadu. And World Habitat Day, what is the theme this time? Frontier technologies as an innovative tool to transform waste to wealth. Frontier technologies as an innovative tool to transform waste to wealth. According to CRISIL, India's GDP growth rate will be what for the financial year 2020? According to CRISIL, our GDP will grow at only 5.1% for the financial year 2019-20, that is the current financial year. Also remember, India's GDP growth for the second quarter of the present financial year was 4.5%. And for the first quarter was only 5%. That is April, May, June 5% and July, August, September 4.5%. Which among the following football players has won the Ballon d'Or award? Ballon d'Or award is given to the best player in the world for 1 year. So every year it is given and this time it is won by Lionel Messi. He is from Argentina and second was Virgil van Dijk and third was Ronaldo. But Lionel Messi, it is his 6th Ballon d'Or. Cristiano Ronaldo now has 5 Ballon d'Ors and is one behind Lionel Messi. Zinedine Zidane is a former player of France. And Virgil van Dijk is from Netherlands. He was awarded the UEFA Player of the Year. UEFA Player of the Year was Virgil van Dijk. And FIFA Player of the Year was Lionel Messi. Don't get confused between UEFA and FIFA. And Lionel Messi has also won Ballon d'Or. Remember, the Ballon d'Or award is given by a French magazine called L'Equipe. And Cristiano Ronaldo is from Portugal. The 8th India-China joint training exercise called Hand in Hand will take place in which state? Hand in Hand. China has recently called Tulagi Island from Solomon Islands. Tulagi Island has been given to China. China also built Hampantota port in Sri Lanka. They got it on lease. And Djibouti, China made a overseas military base in Djibouti also. Hand in Hand will take place in Meghalaya, which will host the 2022 National Games. And Conrad Sangma is the Chief Minister of Meghalaya. Tathagat Roy is the Governor. Capital is Shillong. Which author has won the 12th Shakti Bhatt First Book Prize? 12th Shakti Bhatt First Book Prize has been given recently to Tony Joseph. And which is the name of the book? The name of the book is Early Indians. Early Indians is a book about the story of our ancestors and where we came from. So, Early Indians. There are some other books that were launched recently. You should know Simon Toffel. He is a former 5 times ICC Umpire of the Year. And Simon Toffel has written a book called Finding the Gaps. Finding the Gaps. Then there is a book written by Shashi Tharoor called The Hindu Way. And before this, he also wrote a book called Why I Am a Hindu. Why I Am a Hindu. And then The Unquiet River. It's a book about the river Brahmaputra written by Arup Jyoti Sakya. Three or four more I'll tell you. So there is a book of Bill Gates called How to Avoid a Climate Disaster. This book will be released in 2020, but already announced, so it can come in exam. How to Avoid a Climate Disaster by Bill Gates. Girl, Woman, Other, written by Bernardine Evaristo, and she is the first black woman to win the Booker Prize. And then we have Margaret Atwood's book called The Testament, that has also won the Booker Prize for 2019. There is a book called The Brigital Nation, written by N. Chandrasekharan and Rupa Purushottam. N. Chandrasekharan is the chairman of the Tata Group. Also remember that the Google CEO Sundar Pichai is now the CEO of Alphabet, which is the parent company of Google. So this is a promotion for Sundar Pichai. Which state celebrated the Indigenous Faith Day on 1st of December? Indigenous Faith Day was celebrated by Arunachal Pradesh. Capital is Itanagar. B.D. Mishra is the governor and Pema Khandu is the chief minister. Arunachal Pradesh, they are making a new airport also called Holongi Airport. And there was a bridge, Sisari River Bridge, which was inaugurated by Rajnath Singh recently in Arunachal Pradesh. Indigenous Faith Day. And the celebrations took place in Pasighat. Shelley Morrison passed away. She was a famous what? Shelley Morrison was a Hollywood actress. And she was a Hollywood actress and she also acted in the famous serial Will and Grace. Who has taken over as the 14th Commander-in-Chief of the Andaman and Nicobar Command? Andaman and Nicobar Command, Podali Shankar Rajeshwar is the new Commander-in-Chief of this command. Lieutenant General Podali Shankar Rajeshwar. Andaman Nicobar capital is Port Blair. And remember, there is a police station in Andaman Nicobar, which is called Campbell Bay. Campbell Bay is the second best police station of India after Kalu in Bikaner, Campbell Bay. And Veer Savarkar Airport is the name of the Port Blair Airport. When is the International Day of Persons with Disabilities celebrated? It is one of the most important questions. International Day of Persons with Disabilities is 3rd of December. And what was the theme this year? Promoting the participation of persons with disabilities and their leadership, taking action on the 2030 Development Agenda. It's a big theme. But just try to remember, promoting the participation of persons with disabilities and their leadership, taking action on the 2030 Development Agenda. In the PDF, I will include it so that you can just mug it up. Who was awarded the 2019 Karamveer Chakra by iCongo and United Nations? 2019 Karamveer Chakra was given to Rahul Adhikari. He is the founder of International Changemaker Olympiad. So the answer is Rahul Adhikari. Which of the following missiles got failed in its first night trial? It's a Indian missile and it is nuclear capable missile. It is Agni 3. So Agni 3's night trial failed. It was done from APJ Abdul Kalam Island off the coast of Odisha. Who has taken charge as the President of the European Commission? The President of the European Commission is Ursula von der Leyen. Remember, she is the first woman to be the President of the European Commission. So it's very, very important. Ursula von der Leyen. Which city will host the National Sikh Games 2020? National Sikh Games will be hosted in 2020 from 9th to 11th of January in New Delhi. Siberia Pipeline Project is a project of Russia and which country? It's a very ambitious project from, you know, there will be a pipeline which will extend all the way from Russia to China. So the answer is China. It's actually a 3,000 kilometer long Siberian pipeline. It will transport gas from Russia to China. And there are some fields also like Kovetka and Chayandinskoye. These are the name of the gas fields. And the project will generate $400 billion for Russia. This is the revenue it will generate for Russia. And this project started on 2nd of December 2019. Now let me tell you the name of the places from where the gas will be filled. One is called Chayandinskoye and Kovetka. These are the name of the two gas fields in Siberia from where the gas will go to China. So it's very, very important. Now, there is a Tapi pipeline project also, if you remember. Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan and India. Right? And there, the gas will be filled from Galkinish oil field. In Turkmenistan, it will reach all the way to India. And then there is, of course, the Urja Ganga pipeline project, which will run from UP to Odisha. So it will benefit states like West Bengal, Bihar, Jharkhand, which come in between Odisha and UP. And this was inaugurated by Pradhan Mantri Modi from Varanasi, the Urja Ganga project, and gas will be filled by GAIL, Gas Authority of India Limited. And the chairman of GAIL is Mr. Asutosh Karnatak. Asutosh Karnatak is the chairman of GAIL, Gas Authority of India Limited. Which bank has been removed from the second schedule of the RBI Act? So there are two types of bank, scheduled bank and non-scheduled bank. Scheduled bank are further of two types, the cooperative banks and the commercial banks. Cooperative banks are further of two types, the urban cooperatives and the state cooperatives. And commercial banks can be of many types, the public sector bank, the private bank, foreign bank and the regional rural banks. So these are the commercial bank. And then the public sector banks are of two types, nationalized banks and the State Bank of India and its associates. So this is the classification. It's not very difficult to remember. Basically, if a bank is in the second schedule of the RBI, then the bank is eligible for repo and reverse repo, and that is taking loans and other facilities of the RBI, like the currency chest facility, the clearinghouse facility. All these facilities are given to only the banks in the second schedule of the RBI Act of 1934. So which bank has been removed? It is the Vijaya Bank, because it has been merged with the Bank of Baroda. And Vijaya Bank recently opened its museum also in Bangalore. It's a heritage museum of the Vijaya Bank. The government of Madhya Pradesh, they have applied for the GI tag to which products? Government of Madhya Pradesh wants the GI tag to be given to Morena's Gajjak and also Indore's Poha. So the answer is A and B. Prithviraj Singh Rupun has been appointed as the president of which country? It's a very friendly country. The prime minister of this country is Pravin Jugnauth, and capital is Port Louis. We are talking about Mauritius. Now the president is Prithviraj Singh Rupun. Dictionary.com has chosen which word as the word of the year? According to dictionary.com, existential is the word of the year, because we are using this word again and again, like the existential crisis, you know, for climate, etc. In fact, climate emergency is the word of the year by Oxford, and climate strike is the word of the year by Collins. So you can see the impact of climate these days, that the word of the year of three topmost dictionaries, dictionary.com, Collins and Oxford, are related to climate. Walmart, along with which bank, has unveiled the co-branded credit card for best price members? Walmart has done a co-branded credit card with HDFC Bank. Walmart had also acquired the company Flipkart. Which country has won the gold medal in the men's volleyball team category at the 13th South Asian Games, which are taking place in Nepal? So remember, India won the gold medal in the volleyball category. And in the badminton, both Indian men's team and Indian women's team, they won the gold medal. Who has become Tamil Nadu's first transgender staff nurse to be appointed at a government hospital? Her name is Anbu Ruby. And Prithika Yashini, she was also from Tamil Nadu. She was the first transgender sub-inspector in India. Joyita Mondal was the first transgender judge, and she became the judge in West Bengal. And I'm sure you must have forgotten by now, so let's revise the new districts of Tamil Nadu. The 33rd district was Kallakurichi. It was carved out from Villupuram. 34th was Tenkasi. It was split from Tirunelveli. 35th was Chengalpattu. It was split from Kanchipuram. And then finally, Ranipet and Tirupattur. 36th and 37th, they were split from Vellore. And some static GK for you. I will tell you the grasslands, the world grassland and the India grassland. This is your static GK and quite important. So steppes, they are the grasslands in Russia, mainly Russia, but also in some parts of Europe, but mainly Russia. Grasslands are of temperate and tropical two type. The tropical grasslands are called savanna. Then in Hungary, we have the grasslands called pustas. In America, we have prairies, the North America. Argentina, we have pampas. South Africa, we have veld. Australia, we have downs, especially South Australia. Then in New Zealand, we have the grasslands called Canterbury. By the way, grass are a family called Poaceae. In botany, Poaceae family consists of grasses. In Sri Lanka, we have the Patana grassland. Then all of these are in South America. The selvas. Selvas are mainly in Brazil. Llanos. Llanos are there in Colombia, Venezuela, you know, Amazon area. Campos, again in Amazon area. Brazil, Colombia. Pantanal. It's a wetland basically, but there are grasslands also in Pantanal. And again, the middle part of South America. If I talk about India, we have the Tarai grassland. Tarai grassland are also called Dwar. Sometimes they are written as Tarai Dwar. Because Tarai we call it in UP and Dwar we call it in West Bengal. Both are the same. They are the foothills of the Himalayas. You know, first you have the Great Himalaya, then you have the Middle Himalaya, which is called the Lesser Himalaya. And then you have the Outer Himalaya called Shivalik. And then the slope starts. So that slope is the Tarai. And then you have Bugyal. Bugyal are in Uttarakhand. Khajiar. Khajiar are in Himachal Pradesh. Chamba district mainly. And Banni grassland. Banni grassland are in Gujarat. The runoff Kutch area especially. The Shola grasslands are mainly in the western ghats, but a little part of it is in Tamil Nadu also, but mostly in Karnataka and Kerala. And then we have Fumdis. Fumdis are exclusive to the Loktak Lake. These are the floating grasslands of Manipur. So that's it. I'll see you in the video on 5th of December. Thank you so much for watching StudyIQ Premium.